Hello, I'm R Gordon Wasson. History would tell that I would go on to be the, quote, godfather of magic mushrooms, but here in 1927, I'm simply a banker. Actually, I'm the vice president of public relations here at JP Morgan, and also I'm a newlywed. You see, the journey to becoming the first white Americans to participate in an indigenous mushroom ceremony actually began over 30 years ago with a trip to the Catskill Mountains with my newlywed wife, Valentina. It was actually a year after we got married, still young, carefree, and in love, when Valentina suddenly took off in the woods over the carpeted dead forest leaves like she had seen something. As I approached from behind, she began yelling words in her native Russian language. You see, she was slouched over and caressing these nasty, putrid mushrooms, or toadstools, as we call them in Montana. She was enamored by these nasty mushrooms and insisted that we gather them, all the while laughing at my protests. Later on in our vacation cabin, she would go on to clean and cook the nasty toadstools, and I happily let her enjoy them by herself. But thank God I did, because shortly after, my new wife would almost die. From the day that she recovered and we returned home, we sought an explanation to explain why her cultural background made her so trusting of the mushrooms and my American background made me so wary. Our method was to gather all the cultural attitudes and uses of the mushroom from across the world. We look for ancient names, legends, proverbs, art, and even holy writing that mentioned the mushroom. For we were not really interested in what people had learned from the same books we were reading, but we wanted to learn what the country folk knew from childhood, what they were taught by their original settlers of the region. And as it turns out, this was a very novel field of inquiry. As the years went on, Valentina and I discovered a pattern. Either each culture knew nothing of the mushroom, or they held them at the highest regard. From the deserts of Arabia, the wetlands of New Zealand, the temples of Tibet, and the jungles of India, we found that it was highly probable that before the writings of written history, that our ancestors had worshipped the divine mushroom. Come to find out, my own Montana vernacular of toadstool may have originally meant demonic stool due to old European tales of hallucinations. Valentina and I had learned of a living primitive people in Siberia, six in fact, that used the mushroom in their shamanistic rites. Later research revealed the same with a New Guinea native people, and finally we came upon a discovery that was in the realm of personal research. You see, when Cortez had conquered the Aztecian Empire in 1519, his followers had reported that they found the mushroom use in the Aztecian celebrations, or as it was said on the ships, the mushrooms were served in the demonic Holy Communion. Well, Valentina and I leapt at the Mexican opportunity, and after a few trips, we found information of a valley where the ancient mushroom stones were carved. So after thinking it over, Valentina and I decided to go back. We also brought along an old friend of mine, Alan Richardson. He was a New York photographer who had similar interests as she and I and was down for an adventure. On the evening of June 29th, 1955, in this Mexican Indian village that was so remote that barely any Spanish was spoken, Alan and I had left my wife and child with our gracious hosts and decided to hit the road, for we had heard of a man who may have some knowledge for us. In the heart of the southern Mexican mountains at an altitude of well over 5,000 feet above sea level, Alan and I headed to what us Americans would call the town hall. Inside, we found a man about 35 years of age named Phil Mon. I immediately recognized his friendly demeanor, so after some pleasantries, I took the chance and I leaned over the table to lower my voice. "May I speak with you in confidence? Will you?" he replied. "Help me, please, find the secrets of Nati Shito." When Faban recovered from his surprise, he happily told us to come to his house later on. So after mulling around town for a bit, Alan and I arrived at the mountainside home around, let's say, 3 o'clock, at which Philmon immediately led us down a trail behind his home that led to a ravine. Once down there, my eyes grew as wide as the ranges of Montana. For Alan and I, this was simply the first successful time of us finding the mushroom, but for Valentina and I, this was the culmination of over 30 years of work and inquiries about the divine mushroom. I couldn't possibly tell you how happy I was at that moment. After Alan took some photos, we gathered the mushrooms in a cardboard box and labored back up the steep ravine trail in the heavy, moist Mexican heat. Philmon, not one to let us rest, immediately sent us high above his house to where we could meet the Corienda de Suprema, the Una Señora Mancha herself, a woman by the name of Maria Sabina. Hey, thanks for watching episode 1. As a brand new YouTube channel, there's no way we can risk putting up a 16-minute video for the algorithm. So please join us for episode 2, and if you enjoy, please give us a like and subscribe. Thanks.